Dear friends, we provide you the health education which you want in your career. It will improve your knowledge and will help in your career. Today, we shall discuss urinary system. So we are going to talk about urinary system. So let us start. In urinary system, we shall study the first one is kidneys, second ureter, third urinary bladder, fourth urethra, fifth male urethra, sixth female urethra, seventh nephrons, eighth function of the kidneys, ninth formation of urine, and 10th is disease regarding the urinary system. So first of all, we discuss kidneys. Kidneys are two bean-shaped organ lying on the posterior abdominal wall on each side of the vertebral column. Kidneys are two bean-shaped organ lying on the posterior abdominal wall on each side of the vertebral column. Now we will know what is the position of kidney in the body. The kidneys extend from the level of the last thoracic vertebra to the third lumbar vertebra. The right kidney is smaller than the left kidney. Each kidney measures 11 cm in length, 5 cm in width, and 3 cm in thickness. The outer border of kidney is convex, the inner border is concave, and it is called as hilum. Blood vessels enters and leave the kidneys through the hilum. A suprarenal gland is situated at the apex of each kidney. Now we know what is the structure of the kidneys. Kidney is surrounded by an outer fibrous capsule. Below this lies the substance of the kidney, which consists of, first one is an outer cortex, which is reddish brown in color. Second, inner medulla, which contains pyramids of the kidney. Third, an upper expanded out of ureter called pelvis, renal vein, renal arteries. Now we know what is nephrons. Microscopically, the kidneys are made up of a number of structural and functional unit called nephrons. These are about 1 million nephrons in each kidney. The nephrons consist of two parts. The first one is malpighian and the second one is renal tubulus. So we shall discuss first malpighian. Malpighian, it is made up of Bowman's capsules and glomerulus. It is an upper expand and of the renal tubule called glomeruli, which are packed in Bowman's capsule. The malpighian bodies are present in the cortex. renal tubules. Now we know renal tubules. Renal tubules consist four parts. First, proximal convoluted tubule situated in the cortex. Second, is a loop of Henle present in the medulla. Third, is convoluted tubule present in the cortex. Fourth one, collecting tubules which pass through the medulla and open into the pelvis of kidney. Now we talk about blood supply of the kidney. Kidneys are supplied by renal arteries, which are branches of the abdominal artery. Venous blood of kidney is drained by renal veins, which open into inferior vena cava. Functions of the kidney. The first, excretion of water and waste products of protein metabolism. The second, excretion of excess salt. Third function is excretion of harmful substances, drugs and toxins. The fourth function is kidney regulate the pH of blood. Now we know ureter. It is the duct which carries urine from the kidney to bladder. It is a tube like structure measuring about 26 cm in length. It commences from the pelvis of kidney. Later, it passes down in the abdominal cavity and open in the posterior aspect of urinary bladder. Ureter is made up an outer fibrous layer, middle muscular layer, inner mucous layer. Now we know urinary bladder. It is the pear-shaped muscular sac which acts as reservoir for urine. It lies in the pelvic cavity behind symphysis pubis. The lowest part of bladder is called as base and upper part is called fundus. Bladder has three openings, two for ureters and one for urethra. The triangular area between these openings is the trigone of the bladder. Bladder is made up of four layers, outer serous coat, muscular coat, submucous coat, mucous lining made up of transitional epithelium. The bladder is controlled by pelvic nerves and sympathetic fibers from hypogastric plexus. Next one is urethra. It is a canal through which urine passes from the bladder to the outside. It differs in the males and females, but a sphincter is present in both. Male urethra, it is about 20 cm in length. It consists of three parts. First, pelvic part. Second, perineal part. Third, pineal part. female urethra. It is short and measures about 4 cm in length. It starts from the base of the bladder at the trigone. It opens externally in front of vaginal opening. Next one is maturation. It is the act of passing urine. When urine accumulates in the bladder, it produces stretching of its walls. This raises the pressure within the bladder. This occurs when 170 to 230 ml of urine has collected in the bladder. This in turn stimulates the different nerves of the bladder, and impulses are carried to higher centers which control maturation. Maturation occurs due to contraction of muscular coat of the bladder and relaxation of the sphincter. It is also assisted by contraction of abdominal muscles. Composition of urine. The volume of urine excreted in man varies from 1 to 2 liters daily. The color of urine is pale amber, odor is aromatic, and reaction is slightly acidic. Specific gravity varies from 1010 to 1025. Specific gravity is the weight compared to the weight of any equal quantity of water, and that of water is 1000. Urine consists of 96% water, 2% urea, 2% uric acid. And salt. Now we know about formation of urine. The formation of urine by kidneys involves three processes. The first one is glomerular filtration, second tubular secretion, third tubular reabsorption. So the first one is glomerular filtration. Filtration of water, salt, and other substances occurs in the glomerular filtrate is the fluid that is formed after filtration. About 100 ml of glomerular filtrate is formed per minute. This filtrate passes into the proximal convoluted tubule. Second one is tubular secretion. It is an excessive process which occurs in the convoluted tubules. Abnormal substances or normal substances present in excess in blood are eliminated by the process. Potassium, hydrogen, and drugs like penicillin are excreted by tubular secretion. Third, tubular reabsorption. the rate of glomerular filtration is about 100 ml per minute. So about 6 liters of glomerular filtrate can be formed in 1 hour. But the volume of urine eliminated per day is only about 1.5 liters. It is so because nearly 99% of the glomerular filtrate is reabsorbed. Reabsorption of water occurs in the convoluted tubules and collecting tubule. In addition to water, some salt are also reabsorbed in the renal tubules. Urine is the fluid that result from the above three processes. It enters the collecting tubules and then into the pelvis of kidneys. From there, it enters the urinary bladder through ureter.